No fucking way! No way! What the heck? Are you freaking kidding me? I got a freaking beam. What the heck? First, Liam gets one like a week ago, and I just get a. What the.
Hey guys, what's going on? And welcome to Barry Brothers episode 3. I'm going to be doing these midweek uploads on Wednesdays, hopefully, every Wednesday. And this episode is going to be more orientated towards my account because I've got the most in-game time. So yeah, I hope you guys are looking forward to these. As you see, here's a bit of my bank, my rare bank tab. I'm looking quite healthy already. So I got word from a friend of mine that there was a, not a rune war, but like a pay-to-play war going on. I know one of the teams is called Zero Tolerance, ZT. I'm not sure what the other one was. But anyway, I actually was on Darek's account because I was busy on mine. So I looted on this account and managed to pick up, as you see, a Dragon Spear, Glory, and some Dehyde, and Rune Legs, and some potions as well. 84k cash, I forgot about that. But yeah, once I've got that, I thought, bugger it, let's bank. So as you see, I've already banked that. And then another loot pile, Glory, and Rune Crossbow. Now, we're not going to try and over-loot things. It's boring for you guys to just to see us getting items through looting. But certain things, you just, I don't know, Glories, realistically, it's going to be a really nice way of us getting hold of them, is from these wars. Mystic Road Bottom from the Turoffs. And I've actually found a way of kind of relocating my clips. Occasionally it glitches out and I can't get my clips, so I've actually found a way of restoring them, but I still can't get that leaf bladed sword clip back. I don't know where it's gone. So here you see me, I was woodcutting actually, and there was a dragon impling, and of course Yarnus was not online, so I actually ended up calling Belgian from the CC and he went and caught it. He got some dragon arrow tips, I think, or something. So here's one of the trades, 1.4k cannibals coming straight over to me, as well as a D-spear, glory, gold bars, that sort of thing. Medium clue scroll done there, got adamant plates golded, which is always a nice drop. I can't believe how cheap they are. I remember they used to be 200k each back in 2007, at least, probably more than that actually. What's going on here? Oh yeah, so finally I've got the slayer points in order to unlock the ability to make broad bolts. I still needed a 55 fletching, but yeah, done all the Slayer tasks in order to do that. And my next Slayer task would be 141 Blood Veils. Originally I thought that was really bad, but they're actually really good XP and great source of Blood Runes too, as well as Hard Clue Scrolls. You see a little, what is it, high risk fight, and some guy gets dropped whilst I'm fletching. So I was able to jump on and get some prayer bots and stuff. But yeah, carrying on with the fletching. Doing willow logs that I was given from Liam's account, obviously because he's the woodcutter. And then I was actually in a bit of a rush because we all decided to go PKing. Here's some live commentary. Enjoy.
I'm on 12.
I'm on 59. Just keep going to win me, you and I.
Oh, I'll meet in the middle.
There's a level 70 here.
Kill him. Let's kill him.
What world?
12. You coming?
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm coming.
I'll probably get a fucking log out of time right now, aren't I? Alright, ready?
Hold on.
Quick. Three.
Yeah, I'm ready.
Two. One.
Ugly farmer. You're fucked, mate.
Rich!
GG, mate!
Good game. Oh, got a load of sharks, boys.
Yay!
Prayer pots, superset, lore runes, nature runes.
Oh. I came to the party, where are you guys?
Brown, let's try and find some fucks.
Oh, I found some guy. Found some guy killing my ult.
Really? You got him?
Yeah, I got him.
Drag.
He looks like a bot, to be honest. Not sure what the fuck that is. I'm hitting jack shit with my staff. Fuck, so many splashes. I'm not gonna get the kill.
See ya, mate.
Nah, nothing really. Rune jab.
Sorry, Finn.
What did you hit?
11.
Great, mate.
Coming. Where's the 2?
It's gold.
Bonded.
Wow, a staff bashed him.
Later, mate.
Big fucking specs. Oh, fuck yeah.
How's that not my kill?
I got... Oh, shit, look north. Who's there?
That's a scout.
It's a level 4.
Should probably get out as well in a second. Anything good?
Loads of arrows. Quite.
Dead?
No, he's not.
Okay, yeah, hashtag BB.
Finn, to let you know, someone wants to talk to you in the CC.
Should we come?
Yeah, he's BGSing me.
Should we come in?
Are we going?
Yeah, let's come. He's wearing jack shit.
Give the name.
His name is Ice Barrage.
What?
I'm fucking dead.
Look at Ice Barrage. Oh, fuck. Yeah, look at Ice.
I lost my admin staff. He smited me. Rip.
Oh, no.
Lost everything, yeah.
Yeah, we should get the fuck out. Well, that's a shit call. 2 max pews. Don't log in.
Oh, Jesus.
No, not
yours,
he's wearing
the heights,
he's
91.
Just get out,
fuck's
sake.
I got out.
Yeah, I soon calmed down after that, but that was really annoying to see 2 boys lose their Ivan staffs. Quite funny though. Just making some Alk money here, so I could purchase my first Archer Helm on this account. Always really nice chucking one of them on. But yeah, obviously training range, through Slayer, finally level 58, I can now kill cave horrors. But I just can't access them yet. So, and again, I just like to show you these loots just in case anyone asks, oh, how did you get hold of that? Yeah, I can refer back to them. So, I swapped my Onyx Bolt Tips and Rune Bolts with Amenity, Luke, 4 Onyx Bolts, which out for 8.2k each or so, which gave me even more money to buy the Broad Arrows, in which I just chucked some feathers on, and I've got bolts that are equivalent to the same as Addy bolts, which is really good. Fire Giant's task, and you see quite a lot of herbs and stuff, alking the fire battle staffs, 60 rune arrows in total, not bad. And then the extremely exciting task of doing farming, which we need for Canifus hard diaries, and some also some quests like Cabin Fever and stuff. So yeah, just actually stole some acorns off Liam's account, being the woodcutter again, to plant a few oak trees. Pay this dude some tomatoes. Oh, this is the system update for Zia, by the way. Something that we aren't really going to do. It's not because we're not allowed to, but we just don't want to use Zia, really. You see here me just showing the first exploration of it on this account. And to be honest with you, it was just... Like, it took me about 45 minutes just to get 5% on this farming thing. In fact, I got to 3% and then this fucking dude comes on and PKs me. Which is obviously my fault, I'm in a PvP world, I get it. But, it is quite funny. And yeah, died. got back, I did manage to get back and get my magic secateurs, so... Not all was lost. But yeah, just decided that was not the place to farm. Getting some sweet corn here. That will come in useful when we want to make sweet corn potato. Tuna and sweet corn, whatever it is. Blue drag task. Just a few inventories there. Really useful, obviously, for crafting these hides are going to be. I'm burying the bones at the moment just so I can get 40 towards 44 prayer. So I can use Eagle Eye. And I did get a clue scroll as well. And then on the way back out, I saw this guy who had originally actually had a Ranger tunic on and a Robin Hood hat. Now I know Robin Hoods don't out for a lot, so I played it cool. I ran north of the bank and was like, well, he was just in the hairdressers, so maybe he'll go back in there again. I don't know why he was getting his hair cut, maybe Fally Easy requirements, the diaries. Anyway, he went back in, so I ran at him with my DDS. 912, I was just hoping for that Rambo spec and hoping that he just didn't have food or telly. He did have food and he ran to the bank. A little bit later on, we started scrapping again. Obviously, I've got terrible PKing stats. He pulls out an AGS. I was like, nah. All right, you win. And went back and got a few more hides from Blue Drags. Checking the health of the tree. Give really good XP. I just hate farming, though. such a boring skill. What we've got here, again, another loot, rune daggers and stuff. There's my clue scroll that I was talking about. Get in. Yeah. Swamp requirement. I've done nature spirit, so I should be able to get there. Then I was working towards mining and smithing, because I need that for the Legends quest. And also a few other quests, I can't really think of what now. What? Yeah, but 41 mining there. That was a nice little goal milestone thing. And then using my nature runes to superheat the coal and the iron that I've mined. Motherload mine's great, by the way. Obviously, being on world dependent, I've only used mines in the wildy. But yeah, AFK mining skill is really easy, really fun. And you've got the chance of people sculling on you with dragon pickaxes. So yeah, I don't mind motherload mine. Happy with that. As you see there, a few smithing levels already just from superheating. And also great magic XP. I think it was about 75k XP an hour. So it's actually better than Alking. Assuming you've got the ores. Thank you, Crossbow. Love this series. We get that quite a lot. I'm really grateful to you guys for how much support we get just throughout the game. I've been speaking to the other boys and they're saying the same, people coming up to them. Yeah. Get the odd person going, "You're fucking terrible, mate." But it's quite funny. This is a clip that I actually managed to redeem. I thought I lost it forever. Originally, I just had the... Well, I won't spoil it yet. But anyway, yeah, down at Hill Giants, I was going to go get another Slayer assignment from Vanica. And I run... Well, see this guy, level 72. Full rune, obby cape, colourful boots, yes please. Trying out the Ivan Blast. He's got auto retaliate on. Oh, bless him. He just... I don't know why you're in a PvP world, mate. There's so many... The Hill Giants isn't even packed anymore. Just go to any world. Anyway, I panic and accidentally click on him instead of the door, which means I'm just chasing him, watching him run off in the distance. Manage to squabble around. Last bind I've got. See all my nature runes run out there. Get the bind. Then I hit him, and then I run back trying to chop a tree. Luckily, I get the hit and get the kill. But fuck me, I was so... Oh, didn't want him to get away. Look at that drop, boys. Obby Cape, which we've already unlocked. We've got one from Tazaz already. Rune Kite, Rune Full Helm, Rune Skimmy, and also, at the bottom, Dragon Boots. So, yeah, I need to get the Slayer level, I think 82, is it? To get them from God Wars. But I've already got one in the bank, so that's awesome. At Port Plasma Pacificis, and along comes Liam, who's also been doing some AFK mining at Motherlode Mine, and chucked me his iron and coal and some gold ores as well. I'm using my goldsmith gloves there from the family crest. But yeah, finally get 50 smithing, which is needed in order to do legends, and then complete Shiloh Village quest as well. That's a great source for fishing XP, as you guys probably know, catching the trout in Shiloh Village, as well as the gems here, which you can just mine. It's quite rare getting the good gems, but I just did like an inventory just to see what the ratio roughly was. Quite a few emeralds there, and I also got a few diamonds. This is the uncut diamond. I think I've got two of those. But yeah, I wasn't going to spend all day here. So I should have really got 50 mining here. It would have been quite good, seeing as I'm the crafter. But hey ho, using the furnace here. I can't believe you've got to pay money. You've got to pay like fucking 40 GP or some shit to get in here. Scam. Yeah, again, herb lore. Getting those herbs for 25 for heroes. And some shitty level 1 clues. I did read your comments saying I'll go open them in Etrana. But yeah, it's such an effort taking all your armor off and then putting it back on and then going back to thugs. I'd rather just open them and hope for the best that we get Paige. Getting some secondaries here for obviously Herbie. Again, I could have used the Tower of Life, done the Tower of Life quest. But I still got a bit of wilderness inside of me. I like going back and killing those black unicorns. So getting some chocolate bars. Oh yeah, some of you guys wanted to see my grand exchange history as well. I'll try and add that at the end of the video. If you guys really don't believe us and think they're using the grand exchange. Oh. 60 strength here at Chaos Elders. Then me and Brandon, decided that we wanted to go to Scorpia. But in order to do that, we wanted to get some prayer pots. Neither of us had 38 herb lore, or weren't really close. I think I was 30 herb lore at this time. So we decided to, yeah, do some looting. You see me getting quite a lot of rune arrows there, prayer pot, magic shortbow, that sort of thing. Quite a few, yeah, we probably spent half an hour looting. But yeah, it's quite successful. I personally don't like it. It's a temporary solution. Once we've done two trips at Scorpia, then it's back to looting. I'd rather, you know, have the ability to make prayer pots. But yeah, see me getting the potions there. So bear that in mind. Also, really good XP is doing the easy diaries. One of which, I think Falador needed 16 construction. So I decided to get my hammer and saw out and start making some shit. 5 construction, and then I went to Kilgorim, I think it's called, up near the Rock Crabs, and bought a load of limestone bricks. They're only 32 GP, so I bought 200 of those, and ended up getting 16 construction, and completed the Valley Easy Achievement Diaries, which gives 2.5k in any skill over 30, which is really useful. That's already like literally a farming level, each lamp at least, so 35 farming there. And then working towards the Lumbridge easy diaries, I believe. Just needed a runecrafting level. Yeah. Put some miscellaneous shit going on here. Some trying to get that 38 herb lore, but ran dry of herbs. And then my water talisman. That's right. One of the diaries was to kill a zombie. So when I came down here, I found a splasher. I was like, okay. So Liam brought his cat, which killed the rat. So I was able to unleash my DDS on the guy with his dragon legs. Unfortunately, he wasn't going to be risking those. But yeah, poison hits in, didn't have a ring of life, and he died. Let's have a look at how many airs and mines we get this time. 22k airs and 21k mine runes. So again, really useful, can take those to dragons or perhaps even do my own splashing myself. I will certainly go somewhere a bit more secret than that. Lumbridge easy's done. And again, straight onto farming. I need 40 for cabin fever, so then I can make my way towards the cave horrors and try and unlock some black masks for everyone. I found these two splashes. They're unfortunately too low a combat for me to get hold of, so I just called this guy around the corner and said, "Oh, come over and kill these two." So he did. I don't know why I was saying shit like that. Good fight account. Fuck off, Finn. I get really like panicky when shit like this happens. But I traded him, wanted to see what he got. 1.5 mil cash, 11k chaos, 32k airs, 36k fires. And again, my luck was unreal today, really, finding all these splashes. nice little double 10 KO. This guy was not happy. This was during one small favor. I've managed to stumble across him. Only had 6k mines there, 12k airs. But he was mad. He's like, congrats, you ran all of your 10k airs. I'm like, yeah, well, that's better than 0k. How do you feel now? I was like, yeah, pretty good. He was not happy. I actually ended up killing him after that, just to annoy him even more. I don't get it. If you're splashing in a PvP world, you kind of got to expect that. Finally get one small quaver done. And I can use the awesome, I think, 10k XP lamps, 2 of them, on farming, 39 straight away. Realistically, I probably should have just got 40, but we do need something like 53 for the Mortania Hard Diaries, so I just put it on farming. And yeah, so I sinned as well and went to the Rune War. I know some of you guys aren't happy with us doing it, but it's in our rules. We're allowed to loot, assuming it doesn't happen every day, which it doesn't. It's once a week, and most of the boys, we actually discussed it, and we're not even going to go this Sunday. But if we are short on cash, it's a great way of getting money. Things like construction, making a gilded altar, like converting logs to planks, is going to cost about 3 to 4 mil. Realistically, it's either we sit and do Eki Keys or we do this. There's no difference. This is exciting. Quite often we get PK'd for our stuff. But my rule is, once you get a decent amount, get the fuck out. This guy was on me, but I was able to push south and log away with all this shit, which I ended up alking before I went to bed that night. You see another inventory here with Mad Boy. What an absolute Scrooge. But yeah, alking away. And I think I got about 500k in total from this Rune War. If you guys want to come along, make sure you're in World of Pendant CC. We're going to try and make a little hit squad next time. Assuming, well, whenever we do go next time, it might not be this Sunday, but yeah, be cool to have a little PKN squad. 447k there, 525k in total in bank, getting there. Some agility levels, 42. me and Jordan were doing Zoga flesh eating zombies or whatever it is, and accusing that old man who was lying in bed of wanking. Zoga flesh eaters, that's the one. Get that quest done. Working towards getting into those cave horror caves. 47 prayer, which is needed for this quest. Rum deal, I think it is. No, this is cabin fever. I don't know. No, that's rum deal, that's right. Get the holy wrench. That's some farming levels. Sweet. Ugh, still poisoned, whatever it is. Ooh, look at this, another splasher. Now, if this happens to you and someone's splashing a man, all you have to do is right click and pickpocket him, and that will make him walk away. And then you can just turn around on your opponent and start specking the shit out of him. I advise using poison. That way, if he does Ring of Life, you still got that decent chance of him dying in Lumbridge with all the stuff. Shit amount of mines that time, though, like 300. Pirate treasure done. Cabin fever done. Get 54 crafting there, nearly 55 now, which is going to be sweet. I can do Slayer Helm, which I'm not actually going to use myself, but also Ring of Wealths. Yeah, so finally, I've unlocked the ability to kill these cave horrors. Now, if you didn't know, Zia drops these fucking ensouled heads from certain monsters. Cave Horrors happens to be one of them, which is really annoying because it looks identical to a black mask on the floor. Well, pretty similar anyway, and it shits me up every time I see it. They drop noted teak logs, which is really useful, loads of herb seeds, and also clue scrolls, hard clues. So once I've got a pretty full inventory here, you see, oh, there's 81 nature runes, you get like 4 or 6 at a time. And rune dagger drops as well, which obviously I out. Sorry, it's quite dark. I did change it because I was doing this middle of the night. Couldn't sleep, and my girlfriend was in bed, so I didn't want to wake her. So I had to have the screen down, you know, dark. So then I ran into this fucking clue requirement, which requires the fishing guild. So it was time to sit down with my rod and my feathers at Shiloh Village and get some gains.
And that's exactly what I did. I started Desert Treasure because I did get 75 woodcutting to be able to cut magic logs, which are needed as one of the items to start the quest, actually. And the first boss that I fought was this Desus guy, and he was actually the hardest of the four that I fought in terms of how much food I used during the fight. And it was pretty easy, though. As long as you use wind spells and just keep your health up and keep your prayer up, you should be alright. But I dropped this guy and I got the Blood Diamond. I then went on to fight Camille, and he's kind of annoying to fight, how he does that freeze thing and does melee spells all at once, or whatever he does. But you have to kind of like spam click on him with spells just so you keep casting on him. And it is annoying, but you just got to keep spamming spells and make sure your stats stay up, because it does drain your stats up here. And so I defeated him and then claimed the ice diamond from the troll once I climbed up the little ice path and freed his parents.
Does anyone want to play fishing trawler?
What's that?
Never done that.
The mini game, the fishing trawler mini game.
Oh yeah, is it profitable?
Close.
I then went on to fight the Damus guy for the Shadow Diamond, and this boss is pretty easy in my opinion. All you have to do is cast either Snare or Entangle on him and then use Earth spells. And as long as he doesn't get in melee range of you, he won't do the attack where he drains all your prayer points really quick. So all you have to do is keep running around, snaring him, and casting a earth spell on him. So after I killed him, I got the Shadow Diamond. Oh my gosh, this is awful. I have to use regular energy pots, and they only restore like 10 energy. It's basically click on the potion and then click on the map. Click on the potion, click on the map. Just non-stop. The last diamond I got was the smoke diamond, and this boss is the easiest of the four. All I have to do is pray melee and cast water spells. So once I got the smoke diamond, I had to take them to the pyramid and finish the quest. And once again, I got extremely lucky on this account. I only had to run through this pyramid twice. I only got caught by a trap once on the third level, I think. So I ran through the pyramid and I talked to this guy, and there we go. Desert treasure has been completed. It's not really useful for me at the moment because I only have 69 magic. But as I get higher magic levels, it will definitely come in handy when we PK and boss. And as I end my portion of the video, I want to end on a highlight. You'd think that finishing Desert Treasure would be my highlight, but you would be mistaken. I'll go to live commentary now.
Wee, there we go. Let's go get the reward of... Here we go. Strength is that strength. That's strength and hit points in it. H. Forgotten about. Attack and defense. I'll go attack and defense. Why not? Why not? Several hours later. Yep. Sorry. What? Oh, there we go. I can't remember what levels I was on. But yeah, there we go. That's cool. 49 attack. I was 60 combat with that as well. That gave me 4 combat levels. Here's Evil Dave's part done. I already got the XP in that. There you go, 7k cooking. What else? Yeah, that's it really. Get more gloves though. 5 council members left. 42 cooking. Yeah, that's not bad. This quest took like 20 seconds.
There's Lost City done, 82 quest points now.
There we go, that's Nature Spirit complete. Decent reward, decent quest points. Ooh, 36 crafting as well though. 84 quest points, I can get another 2 Recipe for Disaster quest done now, I think. So that's kind of
a... There's a couple of stuff here what I looted in Edgeville. The Mystics and a couple of Death and Bloods. I'll probably get that Mystic to Amenity. I did loot 2 glories as well, but I forgot to record that.
There we go. 40 range. Can now use. Oh, Ubers. Robin Hood hats. Yeah, I've got one of them. Sweet. I'm just getting Amenity to make me a U short bow, because it's got 40 range. I'm going to give him this Mystic what I looted as well. There we go. Press accept. I have got a Green Dragon's task. I can't remember how many I got, but. This should get me quite a decent... This should get me a few prior levels, actually. I think I got at least 60. So that'll probably get me a prior level or two. I can use Eagle Eye. I'll give all the green dragon arts to Finn. But yeah, let's see how many times I get PK'd.
This clip is really, really scary. I was at Lava Dragons, just finishing off a normal kill. Nothing special. Get my loot. Pick it up. When suddenly... A white dot appears. That is really threatening. I'm really scared. I'm really worried. Try to get the log out. I'm stuck. Oh, no. Oh, he's level 43. I'm just like, are you really? Are you sure? Are you sure you want to do this? And apparently he was. So I fought him for a little while. He's trying to spec on me. Hitting really hard with Ivan Blast. Tries to attack me with the Rune Two-Hander and just gets completely and utterly wrecked. Look at that loot. Rune Two-Hander... Amulet of Glory, Combat Bracelet. Oh, so much stuff there. That was a really good PK. Just saying, I got a massive PK to Jonas too. It was really good. Good stuff. So I followed up my little Lava Dragon's trip with some more questy. Finished Priest in Peril. Probably the last brother to do it, but at least it's done now. And now I've got access to Caniphus. When I got a bit of a call from Amenity, he's being harassed a little bit in Camelot and required a bit of assistance. This seems oddly familiar to something that happened a couple of episodes ago. So I'll cut into live commentary now and we'll see what happened there. where's this guy? Fucking amenity said there's a guy chopping you's skull. Oh, there he is. Hello. I just PK'd another dragon axe.
No.
Another one.
And another one. No, seriously.
Fucking hell. Oh, no fucking way.
Did you record it?
Yep, I recorded it. A second one.
Oh, bloody. Oh,
a fucking second dragon axe.
This calls for a celebration. Wait 1 second.
Oh, god damn it. What the fuck?
Ooh, another dragon axe PK. Congrats, Brandon. Beautiful work there, mate. So 7 hours straight of fishing, and I finally catch 3,444 fish and get 63 fishing, which means I can use my Admiral Pie, by the way, which I got from Scorpia, but I deleted my footage. If you want to go check out the whole footage, it's on Brandon's page, Torag, that is linked in the description. I get Admiral Pie as well as a Rune Warhammer. And finally, open up the clue. Fucking look at that, boys. Green dragon chaps. Now, for most of you, this is a terrible clue, but we've now unlocked the chaps, which I really need to train range a bit more efficiently. I was really excited. Went on my friends list to PM, and then I realised I actually have no mates. None of my BB mates. So, yeah, had to keep that to myself for a bit. But yeah, they're unlocked. That's awesome. Used my crystal cheat on the chest, as I was very near to 55 crafting. A few more air orbs, and I was there. And I can make Dragonstone rings, but I need to wait for Amenity or Brandon in order to enchant it into a Ring of Wealth. There you go, another, that's a black mask, but it's not. Clue, hard clue scroll again. I try and sit it out for a bit longer once, you know, I've got the clue scroll, because that was my second kill. 73 range, but yeah. In order to do this clue scroll, I needed to get a Bone Spear, which requires Death of Durgishan, as well as Mystic Cat, which you see me there getting from Brandon, who got it from the Wizards Guild. And also a Rune Plate, which I've already got some from the Rune Wars. And yeah. Finally, 38 Herblore. And I can now make Prayer Pots, which is really useful. Obviously, same place Luke was getting the Snake Grass from, the Hobgoblin place, because my house is right nearby, so I can just teleport there, straight back to Castle Wars. Yeah, got a couple hundred of those for the future. Super anti-poisons again from the castle, from north of Castle Wars, and smashing out the prayer pots now. These are going to be so useful. We decided to go do a bit of bossing, me, Giannis, and Brandon. Buying out some death runes with my cash stack, obviously. And yeah, we were all set to go. Scorpia was the decided boss because it drops lots of rune items which we can alk. It also has the chance of dropping those two shards. There you go, Admiral Pie drop. It's quite a common drop here. And also the pet. They can drop a pet, so that'd be nice to get our hands on. Weapon poison there, another useful item. Oh, shit, and this is when the PK came in. Giannis actually already has some weapon poison from Chaos Ellie. Super poison, but yeah, he's got an extra bit there. So actually, Liam brought his main up. He was in TS with us, and he tried scaring us. As he came up, this other PK happened to come into the cave as well. So it was, he attacked me, so I was the only one who didn't, obviously I wasn't going to scold, so I attacked back. It was me and Liam against this guy. And then, out of nowhere, again, zero tolerance. If you remember that clan from the war I got the Dragon Spear at earlier in this episode, they turned up out of the blue, literally. No, we didn't call them or anything. And we were really shitting ourselves. But we eventually killed the guy that attacked me, and they were off us. So shout out to Zero Tolerance, thanks guys. And I stayed behind and looted that 105's dehide, pretty much. And down at Lava Dragons, same day, me and Brandon decided to hit it up together. I was getting really lucky with my Onyx Bolt tip drops. I also get a Rune Axe. Again, more PKs here who've seen the series. So shout out to you, Middle Kings, and your boys, helping us out a bit yesterday. And finally, the third drop, they're about 100k each for alks, as you see here, and that was 36, and I end up getting about 300k there, so decent, very decent. Finally get hand boots to finish Death of Durgishan quest, well, more to start it, but yeah, finally finished it. Get my bone spear. Whilst I was here, I decided to get a crossbow and a bone dagger or two. Finally compress on with this clue scroll. But I've unlocked those items now, which is brilliant. Next one was actually in the camp, then in the wieldy. But then this last one, it is in the elven camp. So I needed to get 45 agility. For those who don't know, you don't actually need to do regicide. All you have to do is get 45 and you can get over that log. And yeah, average loot there, boys.
So I figured I'd record my final bank after a few days at Lava Dragons. Just to fill you guys in on how I'm going. I've managed to get 67 mage and 50 prayer over the last couple of days. I know my segment has been heavily dominated by Lava Dragons in the last few days, but I will be doing some quests over the next few days with Lava Dragons as well while I'm doing some quests. I just figured I needed a little bit of money and a bit of a higher prayer and magic level to make questing a little bit easier. So here's my bank. Apparently it's worth 5.7 mil now. I spent that whole entire cash stack on a bunch of casts for Ivan's Blast, so some fire runes and death runes, and I've gotten some more Onyx Bolt tips built back up again. Here are my Dragon Bolts and all of the stuff I've looted or gotten from Lava Dragons, like the rune knives, the rune javelins, dragon darts, all that sort of stuff. I've got some stuff I can alk, and yeah, it's pretty much the same as it has been. I'm running low on sharks, and I need to pick up some more of those. But yeah, over the next couple of days, I will be doing some more quests, and I'm probably going to be tackling all of the free-to-play quests just to get my quest points count up, and doing it in the style of doing a quest, doing a trip at Lava Dragons, and so on and so forth. I've got a few days for hardcore scaping over the next couple of days, so I will get a lot of progress. And finally, my editing and recording style has changed a bit, because I'm now recording all of my raw footage so I don't miss anything, and then having to edit it down. Some transitions and stuff might be a bit choppy, but I'm still figuring this out, and I'm hopefully getting a little bit better at all of this. But I'll leave you guys off with a montage of my best deaths at Lava Dragons, because I did die quite a bit, because it is Lava Dragons, and you just die there. And since Finn said I'm not allowed to use any copyrighted audio, I kind of improvised a little bit, so enjoy.
Cause you had a bad day, you're taking one down, you sing a sad song just to turn it around. You say you don't know, you tell me don't lie, you work at a smile and you go for a ride. You had a bad day, the camera don't lie, you're coming back down and you really don't mind. You had a bad day, you had a bad day. Woo, you had a bad day. Woo.
Holy shit, I actually found that really funny. If you guys want to go check out any uncut Barrows episodes, again, the link will be in the description. That's Torag's channel. Or if you want to go check out any of the boys' channels, they will all be in the description if they've got a YouTube channel. You've got Giannis, you've got Luke, and obviously Torag. And hopefully Jordan will be setting his up. I don't think Liam really wants one. I haven't even asked him. But yeah, go support the boys. Go check out extra footage if you want to, whilst you wait for these episodes. Really hope you enjoyed this one, lads. And yeah, you can click in this box once the next episode's up. I will link it. Thank you very much for watching. Leave a like if you enjoyed, and I'll see you on Sunday, boys. Thanks.